The picture world that falls apart and leaves a snowflake on the hand, a star of ice, a hillside, a dead leaf. The picture world, the lost and broken child's book, whence we treasure one picture torn and soiled, the faded colors precious because dimmed, clear because faded. The picture world which is ourselves, speaking of yesterday and yesterday and yesterday. The huge world promised in the bud of May. The leaf, the stone, the rain, the cloud, the face most loved, the hand most clung to. Must we go back to this and have this always? Remember what was lost or what was torn. Replace the missing with a better dream built from the broken fabric of our wills. Thus to admit our present as our past, and in one picture find unaltered heaven. Or shall we be angelic, close brave wings, fall through the fathomless, feel the cold void, and sound the darkness of the newly known? To face the terror in this rain that comes across the drowned world to the drowning window. Be ignorant of rain, this unknown rain, unknown and wild as the world was to God when first he opened eyes. Ah, surely this were nobler answer than the glib speech of habit, the well-worn words and ready phrase that build comfortable walls against the wilderness. Seeing to know the terror of seeing, being to know the terror of being, knowing to know the dreadfulness of knowledge. Come, let us drown in rain, cry out and drown in this wild single drop, sound the pure terror on steadfast wings, and find in death itself the retrospective joy held like a picture book in a drowned hand.